Right guys, Tom Squire back again today. Hope you're all doing well and enjoying your day so far. Welcome back to Valorant News and the chaos of the World Championship and the drama that has gone down the last 24 hours or so. North America are out of the tournament and MIA are moving on. Some spicy words being said on exactly what is holding back the North American region and how they can rebound going forwards. Very much intrigued to your thoughts in the comment section below. If you enjoyed the video, hitting the like button is the best thing you can do. Top of the channel, reach new people. Please consider subscribing as well if you have not yet already. Firstly, wanted to mention this from Fion, the discussion of agents' pick rates throughout the entirety of the group stage. You can see Jets, Sova, Astra, no real surprise at the top of the list right here. Viper may be slightly lower than I would expect, but down at the bottom, Omen was picked like one time at Phoenix and Yoru, not picked at all. Definitely an indication maybe of what buffs and nerfs need to happen going, well, after Champions, right, I suppose, into the new year and VCT 2022. This also from Jake Lucky, just to mention, because the $7.5 million is going to go straight to the pro players, it seems, as a result of all these skins that got sold inside the game. Kind of crazy, like only a $1 million total prize pool, I believe, for the event, but another $7.5 million straight to the players just because of these crowdfunding skins that have been sold. That's pretty cool. Definitely in the tens of thousands of dollars for each individual player, I would imagine, which is, well, certainly a pretty cool thing to see. I'm not really sure how they get split up between the teams that potentially do better. And of course, speaking of teams doing pretty well, Ascend on the menu yesterday. Let's talk about the team secret series they had. Kind of a surprising one, really. But I mean, finally Ascend reaching that point where they actually looked like a very difficult team to beat. Early in the tournament, it was a little bit suspect. They certainly had their moments, but against Envy a couple of days ago, we really did see, okay, yes, Ascend, they're in the driving seat now to actually make a run here in this tournament. They played Team Secret, and at the end of the day, it was a pretty comfortable victory for them. There was a back and forth here on Icebox. It was, of course, 12-8, as you can see right here, after this nice flank from Borkum, but at the end of the day, Ascend closed the series out without too much of an issue on the next couple of maps as well. So, I mean, yeah, this on Breeze as well was pretty dominant for them. So, yes, you do have to think Ascend, if they're hitting this form, they have I mean, finally their star players really turned up. Like, CNN had a fantastic series as well, and if those guys are playing at the top of their game, Ascend is not going to be an easy team to take down by any means. We'll have a look at the overall series right here. Ascend 2-0 over Team Secret. The Team Secret guys go home, but yeah, they made maybe a better run than some people might have expected them to, getting out of that group as well. But yeah, Ascend definitely the dominant team of this series. I mean, CNN, Zeke, they both had fantastic stuff. Bone Cold as well. Like, I mean, yeah, these are the three guys that generally are putting up the numbers on this roster. When they're putting up numbers like this, they are a very difficult team to stop. Indeed, Icebox 13-8, no real doubt about that one. In the end, Team Secret won a fair few rounds, but yeah, the first round of the first half indeed was pretty dominant for Ascend, and then the second game 13-6, and of course that was their pick, so not really too close at the end of the day. They all move on to the semi-finals, the first team to secure that spot, but of course we still had another series to go on the day, and that was an incredible series between Team Liquid and Cloud9 Blue. These, of course, two teams I would like to have had further in the tournament, really. I think these are both two teams that could have made that happen, and especially with Leaf playing like this. Leaf, I mean, I can understand why people thought this guy was cheating in the Counter-Strike side. This guy was honestly out of control this series. Certainly, I mean, he's pretty much the only guy that turned up really on Cloud9, but even like with him just the only guy doing the stuff on the team, like pretty much this series was still very close as a result of him hitting new levels. Like, it was incredible what this guy was doing, pulling off aces in the pistol rounds and stuff like this, and well, despite Team Liquid doing their best and having a pretty well-rounded performance, Leaf was really keeping Cloud9 Blue in this game at a time. He, of course, the last bastion, really, and his team from the North American region after Sentinels, of course, surprisingly gone in the group stage. Same with Envy yesterday to X10 Crit. And, well, it was Cloud9 Blue holding the flag, I suppose, for North America. And, well, that would come to an end sooner rather than later. But not really their fault, I would imagine, because, well, Team Liquid seemed to be on another level at the present time. This game, one on Bind, goes down to the wire. Team Liquid with a nice advantage early on. But Mitch clutches a fantastic 1v3 right here to, well, to keep them in the game and keep this game very competitive indeed. Cloud9 were making some good plays at times. Like, all the guys obviously were, well, performing relatively well. But, yeah, I mean, Leaf was certainly the standout to this team. It goes down to the wire, and the Vera makes a fantastic clutch in the very final round. This, if anything, I'm not really sure I blame Vanity for this one, just because Navera makes a phenomenal play, really, where he just looks at this smoke, gets the kill. But it was the first kill that he got on Mitch, really, which I think was probably the mistake right here. So Mitch kind of pushed out a little bit, goes down to Navera, and Navera has just enough time, 3 seconds on the clock, to take this kill on Vanity and win the round and clutch up the game. And of course, this was Cloud9's pick right here on Bind. Team Liquid come in and steal it away from them, and they're really good on the other couple of maps remaining in this series, as we will look at here in just a couple of seconds. This also, there was some, well, some banter going on, let's just say, between the two guys, because of course, Linky's gone for that whole bold look, which a lot of people are talking about, and Vanity, you know, he's an entertaining character for sure. Look at me, I'm shaking, stop looking around. Bold, you know, dot, 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 like, yeah, I imagine the asterisk is. Probably replace a certain word at that point. But yeah, this is kind of what was going on in the party chat between the two teams. I'm pretty sure going into either the game one or the game two, but it didn't really seem to affect these guys. So they go on to Ascent, and Clarendon have a nice advantage early on here, but Navero finds himself in a very important one versus two situation. And I mean, yeah, just clutches it without an issue at all. Vanity takes down Soulcast, and then it's Navero in a 1v2, gets the first kill, clutches up the second one as well. And yeah, just moments like this from Navero really just make you think, wow, this guy's on another level. His shots are pristine, and on the main stage alongside Scream, the brother buff really did come through in force. And yeah, moments like this really made this series, to be honest. Cloud9 played really well. I think you can't really take anything away from them, but it's just Team Liquid were just too strong in these important clutch moments. And in the end, it's Scream and Go that get the job done. Scream was a monster this series as well. We'll have a look at the stats here in just a second. But yeah, he was out of control also. Navero was playing great. The rest of the guys held their own for sure, and that was enough to get them over the line. I think I was really impressed by Cloud9 on the whole. I really think they could have put up a good fight against many other teams, but Liquid just seem to be so strong right now. They're going to be a difficult team to stop in the next round and going through to the rest of the tournament as well. Scream, playing like he did yesterday, probably the best player in the game, to be honest. This guy was out of control, hitting headshots like it is absolutely nothing at all, as this guy knows how to do. Of course, what that does mean, North America are now out of the tournament officially, as Ethan says from 100 Thieves, NA Blows. He was discussing yesterday how it's going to be possible to rebuild the 100 Thieves roster, and they're certainly going to have some thoughts about that, especially giving some of these other squads going on right now. Maybe some sort of North American super team can try and form. It's going to be tough, though, with some of them, I guess, the contracts and some of the guys still over in Counter-Strike. But, I mean, and of course, going back to Counter-Strike in, well, Nitro, clearly, and potentially Automatic as well, we did discuss. This also from 10's NA officially dead, because, I mean, yeah, it wasn't official yesterday before Cloud9 went out. Now it's official that, well, North America are out of there. So I'm kind of crazy, right, this early on in the tournament for all of the North American teams to be gone. But, yeah, certainly some rebuilding to be done for that region, I think, in general going forward. Lots of roster changes probably required, but also potential changes in terms of, you know, how they're actually constructing their rosters and how they're approaching the game. Because as Link says right here, you know, 2-0 versus Cloud9, NA needs to start importing players fast. Pretty sure Baby Bay actually said in the replies here, we'll have a look in a second, they're already starting to do that. But there was some talk about the North American region in general. Firstly, there was this from Scream. He kind of says, you know, North America, a bit too predictable. But there was an interview with Link shortly after their match where he discussed the issues with their team and the regions in general. The fact that Tens and Sentinels, they turned up to LAN, woke up and started streaming straight away. Whereas the European guys, they're focused on winning, whereas the North American teams, they're focused on just wanting to stream.
And overall, EU has been the dominant region at Champions so far. Why do you think that is? What is EU doing differently to other regions?
Practicing, not like... And they just seem to, like, I don't know, they're just, like, even when, like, Sentinels got here, like, I swear, like, Ten said he woke up at 4 p.m. and started streaming. So, you know, it's obviously come to bite him, I mean, you know, in the arse a little bit. But, you know what I mean? I really think that's it. I think we just practice a lot harder and we want it a lot harder. They want to stream, we want to win. So, yeah, that's about it.
So I wonder if you guys think this is a fair assessment from Link, really, where, you know, talking about the North American teams, they focus much more on well, streaming, right, rather than do their practice, which, to be honest, looking at the scene in general, you wouldn't be too surprised that was the case, right? A lot of the North American guys, as soon as they do retire or move on from competing, they've got a massive streaming career ready for them to go, which is, you know, obviously maybe it does take away to some degree for how much you're putting in the time, and apparently the European region and the other regions in general do not, well, take the game in that way, right? They focus much more on practicing and being the best team they can be in preparation rather than just streaming, and that might be a key reason really why Sentinels and these other rosters fell off the pace to some degree. Not necessarily the case with Cloud9, but yeah, Link was talking about it certainly right there. Babybase is already on it, right? Potentially bringing over some European players to North America to rebuild some of their rosters. That could be key, honestly, to the success going forward. Wanted to look at the overall series scoreboard as well. So another 2-0 there on the day. Cloud9 certainly could have taken this the distance, but yeah, Liquid just too strong. 13-10 on Bind in the end. Scream had a great map, but of course Navero with that clutch in the final round was very important. And then Ascent goes 13-11. Cloud9 also very good on this map, and they were also very good on Breeze. But I believe Liquid were 10-0 or something combined on Ascent and Breeze, and Cloud9 were like 10-1. So it was going to be a close fought affair, but it's Liquid that get the job done. Scream and Navero, the brother buff, coming through in full force at the end. And Leaf was, I mean, he was out of control this series, right? I mean, look at this statistically. 53 kills for Leaf compared to the rest of his team. He basically has double the kills of his next highest teammate, which is just absurd, really. Like, he has more than double the kills of three other guys on this team over the course of it. The most kills in the lobby by a significant margin, really three world plus over Scream. This guy was doing it all. He was doing the best he possibly could for Cloud9. Just it wasn't enough at the end of the day. And what they're going to have to think about going forwards. Like, Zephyr wasn't great here either, really, over the course of it. And they fall short at the end of it. And of course, this is what it means for the bracket. So today, two more matches going on. Very exciting ones. Gambit Esports play up against X10 Crit on that lower side. And then Fnatic play Crew. Like, I thought Sentinels versus Crew was really good. This series definitely has a lot in the tank, I'm sure, as well. Of course, the winners of these will play the semi and also the second semi on the Saturday. And then the grand final, of course, coming up this Sunday. But very much intrigued to get your thoughts on all this stuff in the comment section below. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did enjoy it, hitting the like button tells those YouTube gods this is a good video. I looks like you should see it as well and upgrade the competitive Valorant community. Thank you as always. Take care. And I will see you next time.